Welcome to the official Prisoner Cell Block H Online Award Ceremony 2013, in celebration of the last two upcoming box sets, Volume 19 and 20. The nominations for the funniest moment are... Alice Jenkins sings.
It's very hot down in that tropic spot where you can meet a senorita who has got the lot. They stay awake all night.
Jay, some people got no bloody self-respect. Get her off.
Leave her alone. She's doing good.
Oh, she's like a giraffe in a pit. You're making a fool of yourself, Jenkins.
On a very little coke and rum, you learn to shake your
right,
hips
love.
And make your pelvis
We will miss all this carry-on.
I've got a good mind to refuse to go.
Don't get weepy, love. We'll just enjoy it while you can.
And every day you'll keep on saying your regrets. But after five, senor, you'll come alive, senor. And check your carcass to maracas and the sound of castanets on mighty bamboo hut. You see the native strut. They give a free papaya if you buy a coconut. But make sure they're real nice before the price you pay. Down South America way.
Lizzie versus the beanbag.
Yeah, well, that was a rotten trick you pulled, Lizzie.
Why? Afraid of what your workmates might think?
No, it's not that. It's just that... Well, yeah, all right, I felt stupid. Come on, sit down.
Oh! Look, get this off of me!
It's all right, it's just a beanbag. It's meant to do that. Just
yeah?
Relax. Hang on.
Oh! Yeah. Funny things, aren't they? Beanbags. Well, there was a time when a man was in love with a young girl. He didn't care if she had tuppence in the bank.
Money's got nothing to do with it.
Well, we don't need your help anyway. Well, now, I'm getting me compensation, and Dora's getting her mother's house, so we can do without you. And bloody thing, no, I don't need your help, and neither does Dora. Good riddance.
Lizzie! Lizzie!
Pixie drops the cake.
Bring it up here, love, and let's put the icing on it.
Oh, get out of our way, will you? We're working.
Okay, don't get off the
floor. Watch out for that wet floor! Oh, good! Quick, put it on the plate!
You need a bloody shovel.
Oh, shut up, you. It's not as bad as all that.
Sorry, Lizzie, what are we going to do?
Oh, I don't know, but I'll fix it somehow.
Oh, look, you could stick it together with bits of jam.
I'll do it, don't worry. None of you buggers mention anything to anybody what happened.
Oh, we won't mention a word.
Well, it'll come up really well, you see.
Lizzie Borden.
I wouldn't go on sitting there if I was you, miss. When Lizzie looks like that, it means she's going to have one of her turns.
Is there something the matter with her?
Mind you, she doesn't mean any harm. But she's always sorry afterwards.
I don't understand.
Well, you see, Lizzie's not a real name. It's more sort of a nickname.
Yes?
As in Lizzie Borden.
Oh.
Please ask him to give me back me axe, miss.
Enough of that. Can't you see that they're pulling your leg?
Lizzie, Amnesia.
Daphne, Daphne.
Okay, what's your name?
I don't know.
Where are you?
I forget.
Where's your cat?
Oh, poor little thing.
Oh, Lizzie, you're supposed to have forgotten.
Karen Travers, the doctor wants to see you.
There's your chance. Mrs. Jackson, I think there's something wrong with Lizzie. She ought to see the doctor.
What's the matter, Lizzie?
I don't know.
It's the shock of her cat. She can't remember anything, doesn't know where she is. I'm real worried, Mrs. Jackson.
Is this true, Lizzie?
Yes, yes. The doctor, is the doctor here? Where am I? Who are you?
Needs a bit more work, Lizzie.
Willie's Amnesia.
What is this place? Where am I?
Now don't worry, dear. Sister Hall said you should rest, remember?
We're taking you to your dorm. What's a dorm?
Oh, dear, perhaps we should have kept her in the infirmary.
Now don't worry, I'll take care of her, won't I, dear?
Is this it?
No, next one, dear.
Sister Hall did say she'd be better in familiar surroundings. Perhaps I should phone the governor and tell her what's going on. Is that where we are? Is this the governor's palace?
What?
Yes, it's all coming back to me now.
Oh, thank goodness for that.
This is the governor's palace, and I'm the princess.
No, you're not. Remember that little talk we had? I thought you understood.
Oh, what a charming room. You must be my ladies-in-waiting, is that it? Where did I put my tiara?
I think we should humour Mrs. B. Yes, I suppose so.
Tell cook I shall have quail eggs for breakfast.
Beecham, I think you've gone a little
bit... I think we should let her get some sleep, Mrs. Barry.
Yes, very well, but I'll be back later to see just how she is.
You silly bugger!
The Christmas Panto.
We'll run this prison as it should be run.
One, two...
Like a concentration camp.
We'll make some changes for the better. I'll be governor. You can stay on as deputy.
Hold it. A man should be governor. A woman's place is in the home.
Who are you calling a woman?
I should be governor. No more visitors.
More time in solitary. And I won't tell you that again. Damn good idea, don't you think, Mrs. J?
Well, it is difficult living alone, Doctor.
Oh, Megsy. Megsy. Oh, Megsy.
Daphne and her plants.
Jeez. I'd love to put you over there where it's lighter, but I don't think Luke... Oh. She's the girl we're sharing with. I don't think she'd like it much. You feeling any better? I'll give you another drink, but the book says it'd be bad for you.
Who are you talking to?
Bertie.
Huh?
My begonia. He's feeling a bit crooked at the moment because he got caught in the fires at Barnhurst.
And you talk to it, do you?
Yeah. It's real good for him. I read it in a book once.
Well, I think you better lend the book to Bertie here. He looks like he's going to cark it.
No, he'll be all right. Begonias can't read, Lou.
You're having me on, aren't you?
Daffy, love, look what I've got for you.
Willie, it's fantastic.
It's dead, too.
Oh, where did you get it?
I traded with that girl, Jacko. She's going to throw it out. I think she gave it too much water.
You see, I told you.
I don't believe this.
Now, love, what have you got to trade? And no more comics. I've got quite enough, thank you.
Well, I've only got some cigarettes.
Well, look, I'll buy those off you.
Come on, dear. You don't get an African violet every day of the week.
No, that's true. Oh, gee, would have got on so well with Fanny. Oh, Struth, I keep forgetting she's dead.
Who's Fanny?
The philodendron.
She was terrific. She had a really good sense of humour, didn't she, Willie? She got burned to death. It's really lonely without her.
Here you are, dear. Give me the cigarettes later. And don't you worry about Fanny. I'm sure there's a big nursery up there somewhere. I'm sure there is.
This is a put-on, isn't it?
No. That's how you get things out of Willie. Weeping Willie, we call her. If ever you want something, you just sell her a big sob story.
And she falls for it?
Yeah, of course she does. And what am I going to do with you? I haven't even thought of a name for you yet.
PMT.
Oh, wonder you haven't got all your mates in here holding your hand. Come on, the jug's boiling. Make the bloody coffee. You can make one for me too.
Oh, yeah, that's right.
You don't have coffee at night, do you?
AM coffee and PM tea.
and the Saucepan.
God, you're bloody useless! First decent bloke you've ever met, and you let an old cow like that come between you. Well, if you're not gonna tell her, I will.
Oh, Lizzie!
Hey! I want to talk to you. Come back here. Come back.
Well, Kevin, save me.
What are you doing here?
She's trying to kill me. This mad old woman's after me.
Good day, Kev. Come to see Dora, have you?
Bee's stripper surprise.
Oh, here it comes, the birthday present.
She's more excited than I am.
Oh, Bee, it's what you've always wanted. It's beautiful.
Well, some of us think it's beautiful.
Keep it down. Bee, this gentleman's got something for you.
Oh, do I get to keep it or can I eat it here?
Oh, Mr. Faulkner, did you see Mrs. Davidson?
No, why?
Oh, because she was looking for you. She said if we saw you, to tell you to go to the governor's office.
Yeah, that's right. It looks serious.
Oh, can you hold the fort?
Yeah, sure. I'll be right. Yeah.
Mrs. Smith, I have a message for you from some friends.
Mrs. Davidson, I believe you wanted to see me.
No, who told you that?
Well, Bryanton Burns. I just took the telegram guy down to the party and that... Oh, God.
I think we'd better join the party.
Joyce tap dances.
Hey, speaking of singing and backing vocals, Mrs. B.
Yeah.
How about a demo of that tap routine again, eh?
Oh no, not now.
Oh, yeah, yeah. Come on, Mrs. B. Come on.
Oh, all right. Judy?
Yes.
One, two, three. Back again.
Laughing gas.
Well, that's a... I mean, Dr. Eastman's a lovely man, but the trouble we had to go through.
Oh, those women don't know when they're well off.
You're right, of course. If they had to pay... Good heavens. Where did they come from?
Oh, they were in the rec room. The women were fooling around with them, so I confiscated them. Oh, they'd have found a way.
Oh, Joe, really?
Oh, I suppose you want to take them back.
Oh, no, of course not. I'm not in the habit of countermanding
orders. No, I know how you like to keep in good with them. Here, I'll make it easier for you to carry them.
That was the most ridiculous and childish thing I have ever seen in my life. Oh, look, you missed one. Oh, dear. I do hope that poor Lorelei doesn't mind living with you. I hope she's got enough sense not to leave her child with you.
She can't.
What?
The court refused custody.
Don't hesitate. Vote for your favourite now. Complete your Prisoner Cell Block H DVD collection with the final two volumes. Pre-order yours today.